My name is Heather Johnson. I'm a wildlife researcher with Colorado Parks and Wildlife. So our study is focused on bears around Durango. We catch bears within about 10 kilometers of downtown Durango, and then we track these bears regardless of where they go. One of the big objectives of our study is to understand how bears are using the landscape, particularly as human development expands in the landscape, how bears are using both human development and natural habitats. For this project, we've got folks in the field about 8 or 9 months of the year. In the winter months, we're tracking those our collared female bears to their dens and getting information on reproductive success and then downloading all those that data off the collars. Today we came to the den of B124, and our big objectives today were, this is a bear that we've had on the air for the last 4 years collecting data on her, and so today we got to pull the collar off because we're done with our study. One of the big things we're looking at is how bears like B124, how they use the natural habitat and how that affects things like how they survive. Our routine when we go to work a bear at their den is leave the office in the morning, we come out, we'll have to hike to the den, about 100 yards out we'll stop, we load up our jab poles, and we go down those 100 yards to the den, we jab the sow, and then usually we just cover the entrance of the den with packs to make sure that bear stays in the den until she falls asleep. And so if we have cubs, we don't immobilize them. Pull them out of the den and we tuck them in a jacket, just keep them kind of warm and cuddled up, kind of imitating their den environment. And then after we're done working the sow, we weigh them, sex them, take a hair sample to get their genotype, and then we pit tag them. And then when we're done, we put all the bears back in the den just like we found them, but then we'll seal up the den again with snow or branches, and then we hike away. And by the time that bear wakes up, we're gone. The bear is sealed back up in the den with her cubs or her yearlings. This study was motivated by the increase that's happened in bear-human conflicts in Colorado. We, as a state wildlife agency that manages those conflicts, wanted to better understand both what was driving those conflicts, what was causing conflicts to increase, and ultimately what do we do about it. For example, we are trying to understand if expanding human development, if that is changing bear behavior and how bears are behaving, whether we might have more bears than we used to, maybe some combination of those things, and then ultimately how we should better manage for that. I think one of the most unique parts of this study is that we're learning a ton about the bears and the ecology of the bears in the system, but we're also learning a lot about the people in the system. We've surveyed Durango residents 3 times over the course of the study. We're really trying to understand this issue of conflicts and bear-human conflicts interactions, both from the side of understanding bear ecology and the side of understanding human behavior and perspectives. Our first publication looked at how bears were moving and using the landscape, and so we find that a lot of the perception of once a bear discovers human food, it never turns back. Our research has shown that that's really not the case. These bears largely want to use natural foods, but they know exactly where to go for sources of human food for subsidy. When we have a poor natural food year, these bears know exactly where these developments are, that they can go and find other sources of food. Then the following year, if there's a good natural food year, they'll go right back to using their natural foods. We also are just finishing up a publication about our bear proofing experiment, where we deployed 1,200 bears within trash cans into chew treatment areas and looked to see whether that was really effective in reducing bear-human conflicts. And we found it was significantly effective. It reduced conflicts by about half. If you want to learn more about the research that we're doing with Colorado Parks and Wildlife, or this bear study in particular, you can visit our website. We've got a research page that has information and publications on it. What it looks like is that if you can reduce that human food available to bears, bears perceive that people and human infrastructure and roads, that's risky. If you can reduce that forage benefit, risk stays high, that you can tip that balance and just not make it worth it for a bear to forage in town, and then you can reduce conflicts as a result.